presence occurs in the right hemisphere of the brain. Virtual communication is not a great way to transmit information, and it is often dominated as a result by left hemispheric activity. Therefore, there is no real connection made. However, we can tap into the ancient principles of storytelling to really engage an audience. Scientific studies, and indeed our own experience, will tell us that when a story is being told and told well, the right and the left hemispheres of your listener's brain become engaged. It even works when it's just the voice. Why? Because primitively, this is how we learned. We are hardwired to learn from stories, and therefore, when a story is being told, the left hemisphere is momentarily silenced, and the curiosity of the right hemisphere is awakened as it asks, what happened next? The empathy neurons, known as mirror neurons, kick in, and even though we may not be fully aware of it, we start to physically experience what the speaker is describing. You may think to yourself, well, I'm not a storyteller, so this is not applicable to me. This is not true for most people. It is simply the ability to describe it in words and in images, some experience or some situation that you have gone through. Patsy Rodenburg has a lovely little exercise to help us develop our storytelling ability. It is the following. Describe a journey that you make frequently. Do it with a sense of forensic and urgent accuracy so that your directions are so clear that you know somebody could easily follow them. For example, you come out of your door, you turn right, you drive up the hill for 100 meters until you come to the traffic lights. At this traffic light, you turn left and you drive along the gates of the park until you reach the end of the park. At the end of the park, you will see a statue in the middle of the roundabout. At this roundabout, make sure that you take the exit on your left, which will be at 9 o'clock, and continue down the hill for 200 meters, passing by two blocks of cafes and art galleries. Right at the end of the street is a four-storied Georgian building with a blue door, and this is your destination. Hopefully that was clear. Now, you would give the same directions again, but this time you give a little bit more detail in each of the points. For example, you come out the door and you turn right and you drive up the hill 100 meters. There at the traffic lights on the left, there's a great bakery where you can smell this real French bread and pastries. And I often just put my windows down early in the morning as I'm driving past to let the waft of the smell of fresh bread come into my nostrils. Anyway, continuing along the park, I love, you know, to drink in the dank air and the musty smell. That is such a relief in the big city, particularly in the wintertime. On summer days, it's just such a pleasure to bring along a blanket and a book and enjoy the chorus of birds and the sound of children playing and the feeling of being a little bit connected to nature in the midst of the concrete jungle. When you reach the roundabout, there is a statue, right? And there's a man standing there with his mouth open and he is pointing. He's kind of a divisive figure in these parts. Part of the community view him as a liberating hero, and the other part of the community as a rabble-rousing rebel. There are often noisy protests there that use this statue as a focal point. And as you continue down the road, you get to see all the colours and the vibrancy that made me want to live in the city. The art galleries exploding in colour, and all the geometric shapes and the rise and fall of laughter and voices outside the cafes that has been a welcome addition to the normal indoor culture that we are used to in this country. So you can see that the more you describe the senses, or rather the more that I'm describing the senses, the more in your mind you are creating and indeed experiencing some of the things I'm describing. Now, obviously it is difficult to do that type of imagery based on storytelling with a financial report. But we can paint a picture because every statistic is connected to a reality that affects people's lives. And the more you can speak about people, the more likely you're able to be to engage your listeners' attention. Another way to think about storytelling is in terms of the classic three acts. Now, this is where we have a situation where, generally speaking, things are normal in act one, right? Then in act two, a challenge occurs and our hero is asked to meet the challenge or thrown into the challenge most likely. They reluctantly agree, and in doing so, they go through a transformation, which is the struggle which brings the story to the point of denouement or climax. And this is where our hero, generally speaking, turns the situation around and brings it to a resolution. The three acts of this story could apply to the reality of any company or even our own experience. And I suppose, for example, right now, we're in the second act of the COVID-19 drama. We still don't know how that one ends. But yes, there have been many heroes called to action. The three-act structure is as old as storytelling itself, and that is deeply ingrained into us from fairy tales to Star Wars. It taps into a very primitive part of our psyche. But once again, the left hemisphere, which is generally inefficient at taking on new information or new ideas, it is temporarily silenced. And now the right hemisphere is activated and invites new information. And it can put things in context, and from there, it extrapolates and synthesizes a meaning. Therefore, you can make your point metaphorically through the use of story, anecdote, or even case study. If you can do that, you can achieve the type of connection that is missing from virtual communication. So, and that can be quite strong. One where we can see the brain patterns both in the speakers and the listeners are happening at the same time for the duration of the story. They're all literally on the same wavelength. But as we are living in a very left hemispheric society and world, where little bits and pieces of information are given out of context, our storytelling muscles might be a little bit weak. So like everything else in this program, it is a question of reclaiming that innate human ability to start to exercise your storytelling abilities using the journey exercise and trying to frame your narrator's journey into a three-act structure. Steve Jobs believed that storytellers rule the world. That is why he spent his time studying storytellers. It didn't come naturally to him. In particular, he studied Walt Disney. Disney always made use of the three-act structure in all of his work. Listen, there's lots of wonderful literature out there if you want to dig deeper and get into this. One of them would be Robert McKee and his book called Story. Another classic would be Joseph Campbell's The Hero's Journey. I too believe that storytellers have tremendous power. Storytelling really exercises the right hemisphere. And if you would like to future-proof yourself, that is where you should be putting your effort. Artificial intelligence is pretty good at replicating what the left hemisphere does. However, it cannot touch what the right hemisphere is capable of. So if you would like to be ahead of the crowd, if you would like to stand out, start practicing your storytelling skills, and particularly being able to use them in this medium, virtual communication, where we are missing so many of the natural cues. This will bring an energy and a humanity to your speaking that will have you head and shoulders above everybody else.